On November 12, 1966, in Clendenin, West Virginia, five gravediggers working in a cemetery noticed something that they described as a brown human being that flew over their heads, gliding from tree to tree. This was the first reported sighting of what would come to be known as the Mothman, an elusive creature that, although now widely celebrated by the town it once terrorized, remains as mysterious as it was on that night that a few frightened witnesses first laid eyes on it. Just 3 days after that initial report in nearby Point Pleasant, West Virginia, two couples noticed a white-winged creature about 6 or 7 feet tall standing in front of the car they were all seated in. Eyewitnesses Roger Scarberry and Steve Mallett told the local paper, the Point Pleasant Register, that the beast had bright red eyes about 6 inches apart and a wingspan of 10 feet, and that it seemed to want to avoid the bright headlights of the car, likening it to a moth. Knowing how absurd this must have sounded to a local paper in a small community, Scarberry insisted that the apparition couldn't have been a figment of his imagination, assuring the paper that, if I had seen it while by myself, I wouldn't have said anything, but there were four of us who saw it. According to the witnesses, the Mothman was able to fly at speeds greater than 100 miles per hour, which was witnessed after the creature allegedly chased their moving vehicle to the outskirts of town as they frantically rushed to the nearby sheriff's office. It is worth mentioning that all of the witnesses from this sighting were interviewed separately, and all gave the same account of what happened, and all gave the same description of the creature. The sheriff's deputy, who was on duty the night of the report, said that he could see the terror in all the witnesses' eyes, and was convinced that they were not lying and did indeed see something that night. It didn't take long for these two reports to get out and inevitably terrify locals. In fear that this creature was still in the area, the residents took up arms and began searching the area to try to track the beast down and kill it, but their search turned up nothing. On the night of November 16, 1966, the night after the creature was sighted by the two couples, Marcella Bennett was walking to her car while carrying her infant daughter after visiting a friend's house near the area where the creature had been witnessed. She claimed that she saw the creature out of the corner of her eyes as she was unlocking the car door. She first saw a man's legs that looked like they were covered with gray feathers. She did not see any feet. The wings were drawn in towards its body. She saw no red eyes, but later said she might have been too frightened to notice. Marcella described the creature as, quote, over 6 foot tall with feathers. It just looked like a giant bird, but yet a man, and it was standing with its shoulders arched and its neck down. She was terrified, but unable to run. Quote, I just stood there and looked at it, but I couldn't figure out what it was that I was seeing. Her brother saw it, but would not come towards where it was. He kept yelling for Marcella to run, but she was paralyzed by fear. When Marcella finally managed to turn around, she took a few steps towards the house before falling to the ground in a state of shock on top of her daughter. She was unable to get up as if in a trance. I just couldn't do what my mind was wanting me to do, she explained. Marcella had heard the flapping of wings as she laid on the floor. After pulling herself together, she picked up her child and ran to the house where they then reported the incident to local authorities. More and more sightings were reported in the Point Pleasant area over the next year. The Gettysburg Times reported 8 additional sightings in the short span of 3 days following the first claims, including 2 volunteer firefighters who supposedly saw what they described as a very large bird with large red eyes. One sighting, reported by a West Virginia resident, Newell Partridge, told of strange patterns that appeared on his television screen one evening, followed by a strange sound just outside of his home. Shining a flashlight towards the direction of the noise, Partridge supposedly witnessed 2 red eyes resembling bicycle reflectors looking back at him. Dr. Robert L. Smith, associate professor of wildlife biography at West Virginia University, dismissed the notion that a flying monster was stalking the town. He instead attributed the sightings to a sandhill crane, which stands almost as tall as the average adult man and bears reddish flesh around its eyes. In 1975, author John Keel conflated supernatural events and other disasters with the Mothman sightings, as well as reported UFO activity, to create his book, The Mothman Prophecies, which inspired the 2002 movie of the same name. Keel even went so far as to connect the creatures to the collapse of the Silver Bridge on December 15, 1967, just 3 days after the 1-year anniversary of the first Mothman sighting. The bridge, which connected the states of Ohio and West Virginia, was the main route into the town of Point Pleasant. The collapses resulted in the deaths of 46 people, 2 of which were never found. On the day of the disaster, locals reported seeing something stood on top of the bridge. Many people, including Keel, believe this to have been the Mothman. After the collapse of the bridge, the sightings of the Mothman stopped, and the creature has never been seen since. Although, the legend of the Mothman still lives on today. In the town of Point Pleasant, there is a Mothman Museum and Research Center which is open 7 days a week, as well as a 12-foot-tall chrome-polished statue, complete with massive steel wings and ruby-red eyes. Through these, as well as the books, films, stories, and documentaries, the legend of the Mothman will live on and will continue to leave us wondering what did the residents of Point Pleasant actually witness all those years ago. Thanks a lot for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe to keep up to date with our videos. See you next time!